Fabric Flammability Enclosed Part 1.
I'm Jan Stone from Iowa State University, and today we want to talk a little bit about fabric flammability. We don't like to think about it, but most of our clothing will burn. This program was planned to help you learn something about fabric flammability so that you can help your family and others around you learn to be more safe. You'll soon see that we've taped this program in several segments. Part of the filming was done at my home as I visited with my neighbor Marge Smalling and her two sons. Other TV stars in the show are Gretchen and Kimberly Oldehoft, my neighbor's daughters, and my own two sons. Part of the filming was done at the textile laboratory at Iowa State. We used samples for the burning that were the same size as required in the children's sleepwear standard, but the equipment used was not the same. The first part of this videotape will explain the common ignition sources for clothing fires and who is most likely to get burned. It will also show some common burning behavior, how fabrics do burn, and discuss some common textile terms that you find in relation to clothing flammability. Clothing does not catch fire by itself. It has to have some ignition source. Our recent efforts to conserve energy have led to greater use of wood-burning stoves, fireplaces, and space heaters. These are all potential hazards for causing clothing fires. Flammable liquids, such as paint thinner and gasoline, are also common ignition sources. Of course, cigarettes and cigarette lighters and matches are sources. Decorative candles are a potential hazard as well. Sometimes when children are left unsupervised, they get into playing with matches and a fire starts as a result of that. The people most likely to die from clothing fires are children under 5 and the elderly. It's been found in recent research that men are more likely to be burned than women in the middle-aged range, and this is probably because of job-related fire hazards. While middle-aged persons are more likely to be injured, it's still true that the elderly and the children are more likely to die from clothing-related fires. So these are the persons that we particularly want to think about when we're thinking about clothing safety. Elderly persons may be slower to react and slower to put the fire out, and children may not understand the danger associated with fire and not know what to do to put the fire out. So we really want to think about ways to make their clothing safer. Flannels and flannelettes have long been popular for sleepwear and for shirting fabrics. They have a warm, fuzzy surface and that has been napped, and this makes them feel warm and soft. Unfortunately, these fabrics can be highly flammable if they're made from cotton or cotton and polyester fibers. Here we have a cotton and polyester on the right that might be used, for example, in a nightgown, 100% cotton in the center, and an 80% wool, 20% nylon on the left. These two might be used for shirting fabrics. You can see that if you wanted to choose a safe garment for winter wear, you might be better off to think about wool, even though it costs more and presents some problems in care. Wool is naturally more flame retardant than other fabrics. If there's one fabric that's truly as American as apple pie, it's blue denim. And this denim fabric is an example of one that might be found in your denim blue jeans or other denim sportswear. Here we are igniting a 50% cotton, 50% polyester denim. You'll notice that it does ignite It does burn. And because of its weight and the tightness of the weave, it burns rather slowly. You would have a little margin of safety to get this fire put out. But if you didn't get it put out, you would have a very bad burn because this fabric is highly flammable in the last analysis. If burning denim has alarmed you, you may be wondering about other fabrics. Nearly all fabrics that we have in our everyday clothes are flammable. Here we have an example of a percale that might be used in a shirt fabric and a corduroy that might be used in trousers. Let's see how these fabrics behave when they're ignited with a match. You'll notice that the lighter weight percale fabric burns much more rapidly than the heavier weight corduroy. This offers some advantage because the corduroy that burns slowly can be smothered and put out more easily. However, if it's not smothered and burned, put out, it burns longer. And so you would have a chance of having a very severe burn from a fabric such as this. Both of these were 50% cotton and 50% polyester fabric. The main difference was in the construction and the weight of the fabric. It's common knowledge that cellulosic fabrics such as cotton and linen and rayon burn very easily, but some people wonder about the flammability of synthetic fibers such as nylon and polyester. Here we have a polyester suede on the right, and in the middle, a 100% Kiana nylon, and on the left, a 100% Kiana nylon that's backed with 100% cotton. So that comes out to be 50-50 in my book, although that wasn't the way it was labeled. Let's see how these burn. We may have to reverse this one to see what's happening. In this case, the cotton backing makes a somewhat flame retardant fabric quite flammable. And the backing, which is cotton, feeds the flame and causes it to continue burning. Now, synthetic fabrics are highly variable in their flammability, so often they aren't marked flame retardant. And there's no ruling for general wearing apparel in relation to its labeling concerning flammability. Fortunately, we do have a standard for children's sleepwear. This requires that all children's sleepwear sizes 0 to 14 be tested prior to its sale in the consumer market. Recent incidents of burn injury has decreased, and some people feel that this is because we have this children's sleepwear flammability standard. Other people feel that the reduced incidence of injury is because people now are more aware of the hazards involved in fabric flammability and are doing more to keep people safe. Here I am visiting with my neighbor, Marge Smalling, about fabric flammability. The Children's Flammability Standard went into effect in 1972, but there are a lot of people that don't understand what the Children's Sleepwear Flammability Standard is all about. And we have sleepwear on the market now for children, which is flame retardant. Marge was uncertain about the meaning of the term flame retardant. Flame retardant means that the sleepwear fabric, if it's ignited, will burn slowly. It gives the child a margin of safety. It allows some time to put the fire out. And most flame retardant fabrics will self-extinguish or go out by themselves if the source of the flame is removed. It's important to understand the difference between flame retardant fabrics and others because they do look and feel very much alike, but burn very differently. Let's compare some sleepwear fabrics that do look and feel the same and see how they burn.
They differ a lot in flammability. And
here we have on the right a fabric that is polyester and cotton 50-50, in the center at 100% cotton, and on the left, 100% chem-free polyester fabric. You can see that the chem-free fabric is much more flame retardant than the others. The chem-free polyester would pass the children's sleepwear standard. When you shop for flame retardant sleepwear, it's a good idea to get in the habit of looking at labels. In this case, Marge was asking about the term chem-free that she saw on a label for sleepwear.
What does chem-free mean?
Chem-free means that this fabric had no other finish added to it. The fibers in the fabric are inherently flame retardant. That means that they burn slowly by themselves and then they go out if the source of flame is removed. Earlier flame retardant fabrics had to have topical finishes added, and those finishes were thought to cause cancer in laboratory animals. We don't have to worry about that with these kind of fabrics because they have no extra treatment added. Fiber content on labels is very important. For example, acrylic and monocrylic sound very much the same, while in fact the two have very different burning behavior. The acrylic fiber is highly flammable and burns with a big flame and a lot of dripping, burning melt. The monocrylic fiber, on the other hand, has been chemically modified so that it is flame retardant. This is the fiber that's often used in children's sleepwear. Marge was unfamiliar with the SEF monocrylic fiber, and she asked me about it.
What does the SEF monocrylic mean?
Well, the SEF monocrylic refers to the fiber content of the pajamas. There are some fibers that are inherently flame retardant, and monocrylic is one of them. SEF is a brand name or a trade name for a monocrylic fiber. This particular pajama that Robbie is wearing is made of SEF monocrylic blended with polyester, and that makes a fabric which is highly flame retardant and will be a very safe garment for the child to wear. This is an example of a flame retardant monocrylic garment. We've tried to ignite it, and it didn't want to ignite. We can see here that as we put it in the presence of a flame, it tends to shrink away. And even if we try to ignite it in an area where that is not as thick as the hem edge, it merely shrinks away and self-extinguishes. This is a characteristic of a flame retardant fabric, that they shrink away from the flame, they tend to extinguish when the source of the flame is removed. Another man-made fiber that's used for flame retardant sleepwear is the cordylon matrix fiber that's 50% vignon and 50% vinyl. We cut a sample from this pair of sleepwear and we'll see how it behaves in the presence of a flame. Notice that it tends to shrink from the flame. But even though I hold it there for a long time, it doesn't want to ignite. And so we have to conclude that that fabric is flame retardant.